What's up guys, this is Sam here, and I'm back with my last episode for Travel Escapades, Spiti Valley Adventures. In the previous episode, we covered Thabo and Ki Monastery, marking my epic journey to the Himalayas. This episode, I'll be taking you to the beautiful Chandratal Lake and my way back home. So, here we go. Before reaching Kunzum Pass, I stopped at the roadside dhaba known as Kunzum Dhaba. This family-owned dhaba is a nice silent place for people to just chill on their own.
Hey, Mr. Drone.
That was Hitesh, by the way, and he was very fond of calling me Mr. Drone. One thing that I noticed was that more than the snacks and the beverages sold over here, they were habitual to sell conversations. Talk about travel, postcards, memories and more. It was a beautiful place to sit, relax, plan trips and enjoy a warm cup of Himalayan chai. The locals didn't shy away when they saw me with my camera and they still continued their conversation. Everyone in Spiti is so friendly and generous that I was overwhelmed by their hospitality. I wish I could stay in this place a bit longer and get to know more about the social life of the locals, but the journey ahead was calling me. While everyone waited for their orders to be served, I took this opportunity to catch up with my fellow travelers, Hitesh and Naina Tanki.
So, kaisa raha aapka experience?
Inko puchiye. First off-roading experience.
First off-roading experience.
Acha raha. Bahut acha raha. Badhiya ekdum.
To aur baithenge aap?
Haan, zarur.
With all the delicious aroma of the food, I couldn't resist myself to walk into the kitchen and speak to Rakesh and his father.
This
father and son duo run their dhaba and serve everyone with a big smile. So my stomach and heart was full with Spitian delicacies and lots of love for these gentlemen. And now with our bellies full, we hit the road again. One important tip, if you drop your bike parts, then please carry it with you, because there will be no repair shops, nor a town from here to give you back what you lost. This one belonged to Hitesh Bhai's motorcycle, and we carried it to surprise him. Kunzum Pass, or Kunzumla, is the highest mountain pass on the eastern Kunzum Range of Himalayas. Motorbiking enthusiasts are very familiar with this majestic gateway that leads to Lahaul and Spiti Valley. Kunzumla holds the rank of one of the highest motorable roads across Kunzum Range. This route is so beautiful that people take a halt here to indulge in photography and to view the magnificent Parasigiri Glacier, the second longest glacier in the world. A combination of rugged terrain, water-filled mountain roads, breathtaking landscape and cold atmosphere makes the crossing more thrilling for every traveller who is marching towards Chandratal Lake. Finally, on the 8th day, I reached Chandratal Lake. Chandratal has many moods that can surprise the visitor. Nestled in the middle of the snow peaks in the Himalayas, the deep blue waters of the mountains reflect equally blue skies and the heavenly landscapes. I have been fortunate to travel to the mountain regions of Chandratal and capture the majestic beauty of these landscapes and the crescent moon lake. So I set my drone to take its flight and capture this thing of beauty. So here we go. After spending my first ever night in the sub-zero temperature at the base camp, I had to struggle a lot to get up and move out of the layers of quilt and blankets. But the scene outside my tent was just amazing. Camping at Chandratal Lake is one of the highlights of the trip to Spiti. This was my tent and I spent the night like a king. Undoubtedly, it was the best campsite near Chandratal Lake with all the amenities and managed by Mr. Tenzin. This large tent is the kitchen and reminded me of the tents from Harry Potter. Everyone over here is sleeping and sleeping and still sleeping. But some campers were awake, so I went there and had some conversation.
Morning. कल देख लिया रात को. आ गया.
Ultimate.
अरे सो गया था. कब निकलने वाले?
बस हम निकल रहे.
So it was still the wee hours in the morning and I had some time to kill, and it happened to be the drone time of the day. I was enjoying every moment and getting used to this life without social media or cellular network. So I would really encourage everyone who wants to make it to Spiti. First of all, you have to forget where you come from and start appreciating nature and food and the people with whom you are spending time with. After a few hours, everyone was awake and there was a bad news around the campsite. That could mean only one thing, a big landslide, causing everything to stop.
Abhi. Dadu. Samir, lage kare.
तो अभी इधर से हम जाएंगे चाचा जी के पास नीचे बातल में.
अभी क्या कर सकते हैं हम लोग, अगर अटक गए तो अटक गए.
Sometimes nature will display its unpredictable side and we just have to find places where we can rest. So with this unpleasant news, there was a high probability of getting stranded in Chandratal or Batal for a day or two. That is of course if the roads are not clear, and I would also have to miss my flight on day 11. Nevertheless, we decided to go to Batal and see the seriousness of the situation. I reached Batal around 9 a.m. and confirmed the routes towards Manali were closed indefinitely until the pass was cleared. So here I was, stranded in the landslide, and I had all the time in this world. But life for the Spitians was business as usual. For instance, I saw this herdsman carry ration and all the necessary items for himself and his horses. These simple folks were well equipped to face any harsh weather and to manage their daily chores without any hassles. In this region, all the dhabas double up as night shelters for travelers. One such dhaba is the Chandra Dhaba, managed by Dorje Bhut and his wife Hishe Chumo, also known to many as Chacha and Chachi. Dorje Bodh is also a famous recipient of the Godfrey Philip Award for rescuing travelers caught in sudden weather, snowfall, landslides, and also other emergencies. In this wilderness, I made two new friends. Meet Dharam. Dharam was not a talkative type and was only interested in the sweets I carried, but he followed me everywhere. And meet Veeru, who had similar interests like his buddy Dharam. My new buddies liked me very much and they never lost the sight of me. For all those who love extreme adventure, there is plenty of place around to pitch tents and enjoy starry nights. Besides, there is also a PWD rest house in Batal, just opposite the Chandra Dhaba. This was the first time in my life that I was excited and bored at the same time. Excited because of the adventurous journey and bored because I had to kill time. I still kept on filming cause that is what I do, capture selfies, mountains, people and even waving anyone who passed by on foot or vehicle. Then I decided to have some more fun with my new traveling buddies.
One, two, three, four. Left, right, left, right, left. One, two, three, four. Left, right, left, right, left.
अरे क्या कर रहे हो?
Start. Left, right, left, right, left. Left, right, left, right, left.
Eventually, I did use their footage for a teaser that I made for Travel Escapades. Somehow, I closed my day eventfully and I rested in one of the shelters provided by Chacha Chachi. In these 9 days, I made some new friends and we shared our experiences of our trip at nightfall. And I'm sure after watching this video, they'll remember all the good times we had together. On day 10th, we were informed that the route to Manali will be open in few hours, and I was relieved to hear this pleasant news. There was yet another landslide in the middle of nowhere. And since morning, every commuter waited for the bulldozer to clear the road ahead. This is what happens when boulders and rocks fall from the mountain during landslide. But that was a false alarm. The bulldozer kept on clearing the debris from the landslide, and then we waited. Every person at this juncture had spent one extra day or two at Batal or Chandratal for the road to be open, and none of them were going back. That included me too. And finally, the path was clear. I thanked God that everyone stranded in this place were now safe to travel. That included those traveling to Chandratal and vice versa. But it was evident that I won't be able to stay in Manali because next day my flight was scheduled to take off from Chandigarh to Pune. All in all, I was happy to move ahead. In the last 10 days, Spiti gave me loads of beautiful memories and friends for life. Reminiscing the moments, hopping from one destination to another, gorging on food, and finally losing oneself into a satisfying slumber is what I loved about this place. you ask me what did I do in Spiti, then there's not a lot I did there, if you don't count chilling as something. But I did something different over there. I travelled far to see the snow-capped mountains, relived a better 9-to-5 day, hawked over Himalayan delicacies, even gave lips to strangers and hitchhikers, made new friends, shared stories, and explored and captured amazing memories in my camera. Now that's a lot to digest in 10 days. Back in the present day, when I ponder upon how I started traveling to known and unknown destination, the inception of exploring and creating memories was seeded deep inside me even before realizing that I had a passion for travel. Something second to my nature is to keep a journal or a sketchbook to preserve my most profound memories intact. Therefore, this video is a reflection of what I've seen and experienced in Spiti. I still have a bucket full of places where I want to go, but now I just don't want to create memories, but to inspire people to travel and explore that travel bug in you. So stay tuned for my next adventure. So remember to travel far and meet yourself.